Now, beyond the completion of the pattern part, as this is the last pattern, right? This pattern is slightly difficult. I won't say it is difficult, but it's really interesting. Why it is really interesting? Because it is giving you the knowledge of two letters which is fused together. Fused together means the letters are joined together. So the letter L that you have already learned in last pattern, as well as the letter P. See, this is the letter P. So for P, you will write like this. This. L P. You have to understand this pattern more seriously. Why it is like so? Because in this pattern I am using four lines. So all the four lines, that is two blue as well as two red lines, are used properly. Why it is like so? Because I am showing you here. In L we write, we start from blue line and we go till red line. Okay? And in letter P, we start from blue line, but to the end we go down to the red line. So you have to understand this. In red line, in letter L, I have to go L upwards, right? And in letter P, I have to come downwards to touch my red line. So hope this is clear. Yes. See, I do it once again for you. In red line, I am going upwards from this blue line, and in P, I am coming downwards. This is my pattern number 12. So I do it once again for you all. This is the pattern number 12, right? I'll do it once again for you all. Starting with the blue line, going upwards till red, coming down to blue till red line, then upwards for letter L, then downwards for letter P, or L, P, going up till red line, coming down till red line. For letter L, going up till red line. For letter P, coming down till blue, red line. So hope this is clear to you all. I am moving little bit slowly, but you all should do it slowly, as you have to get control on your hands, on your fingers for the lining concept. So hope this is clear. Yes. Last time. As I always say, cursive should be written slantly, like this. Hope this is clear to you all. With this, now onwards we will understand how to write the letters. So